Guys, welcome to W3H video. Today I'm introducing a new DCTL called LAB Crosstalk. It is similar to RGB Crosstalk. This DCTL is designed in such way L output values stay always 1 and same for the A output and B output. So I categorize this DCTL in 3 sections from most used to least used. With the first slide, in first section, you are moving color clockwise, imaging an imaginary axis along with the skin tone and tilt line. You are moving color clockwise with the help of first slider and anti-clockwise. I limit the slider value up to 50%. It's not going all the way, but you can see here in this example, it's moving clockwise and with the second slider, it's moving anti-clockwise. In second section, you are adding red color. If you are moving to the right, adding red color to the image or green color to the image. And in second section, second slider, you are adding yellow color and blue color. And with the help of third section, you can control your luminance of image. As you go this direction, it will decrease the luminance. If you go negative, it will increase the luminance. But one of the best use of this slider, you can use as creating color contrast. You can set same value, but in opposite direction to create color contrast. And here you can create saturation and you can control hue rotate if you want, and it is for gamma compress. But for the clamp, let's go to the fusion page. As you increase any slider, values going out of RGB queue, but with help of clamp checkbox, you can clamp that to the RGB queue. And compress gamut slider, you can compress your gamut of the image too. So you can download this DCTL from my website. This was LAB Crosstalk DCTL. Hope you find this video helpful. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Thank you.